Hi! In this video, we are going to install a Wi-Fi Birdbox camera into this birdhouse. Also, place this birdhouse on a tree. We'll use the Wi-Fi camera because we cannot wire the cable from the birdhouse and enter the building and access the router. But the first thing to use the Wi-Fi Birdbox camera is we need to make sure the Wi-Fi coverage is strong around this tree. Okay, now let me just get the mobile phone. It's quite easy. And what I need to do is just access the Wi-Fi setting of the mobile phone. This is the Wi-Fi. My mobile phone is connecting now. You can see it has almost the full signal string. So that means it's good to use the Wi-Fi Birdbox camera. If the Wi-Fi signal is not strong and sweet, you can use the Wi-Fi repeater. Just reference my another video how to use the repeater to work with the Wi-Fi camera. Okay, you see the Wi-Fi camera is not actually wireless. It still needs the power. Unless you use the battery. So we need to find the power source to power this camera. Okay, let's just look around. Here we got the AC outlet. That would be great because we can connect the power source to this AC outlet and supply the power to the camera. The power adapter will convert the AC to the DC, so it's the safety power will travel through the cable. Okay, now let's get started, see what we need. And we need this. This is the power adapter we are talking about. It's the outdoor type, also waterproof. And this is the cable. We will need to connect the cable to the adapter later. This is the 10 meter extension cable. It's about 30 feet. So we can just wire the cable from the adapter, the AC outlet to the birdbox. And here's the camera. This is the Wi-Fi camera. It's the waterproof version. And why the waterproof is so important, we have another video to compare the waterproof and not waterproof version. Alright, and first thing we need to install an antenna. This is the small antenna. Now the antenna is ready. Let's just attach this camera to the birdhouse. This is the bracket. I have put the bracket already. You just need two screws to fix the camera to the bracket. Let me just get the screw from here. Let's try to complete the first one. I think it's more easy for me to manage in this way. Okay, we still have another screw need to attach so we can hold the camera to the bracket. Okay, now the camera's ready. We're going to wire the cable. This is not decided to lay out the cables. Okay, the second thing is just power up the camera, test everything before we hand the camera to the tree. And we need this power adapter. This is the power adapter, waterproof type. And here we have locked to make sure it's waterproof. And we got the 10 meter extension cables. It's also waterproof. You can see we have locker to make sure the whole connection is waterproof. You're not going to get the water through the connection. Let's find another end. Coming to the camera. Also, we have the lock. It's very important to lock here. And this is the reset button. We are going to use this reset button quite soon, but first let me just put it cover. All right. Let me just connect the cable and got the power for the camera. It's a little bit messy and later we'll just put everything in the road. Okay, here just pop the camera. Let's go back to the birdhouse. It will take a while for the camera's reboot. Now we need to bring up the mobile phone and connect the camera to the router. You see, the camera need to know the Wi-Fi password and SSID. So we need to have the help with the app. Okay, let's move to the app. Now let's just click the app button and we choose the Wi-Fi camera. From here, click next. Next.
Please input Wi-Fi router password and click OK.
Here, it's the information of the mobile phone connecting to the Wi-Fi. I mean, this Wi-Fi information will send to the camera soon. Click confirm. Now click next. Okay, at this moment, I need the camera to scan the QR code. So it will supply the username and password to save to the camera. Let's just wait for a while. I think, you see, that when I see this interface, which means the camera already connected to the Wi-Fi and the camera asking the new password, it's important to mark down this password if you decide to use password. But now I don't want to add any password, so I will close the app. And I log into the app again. I just use a local login. Okay, we can see the camera's live. Now this is the live video from the camera. Okay, let me just place. You see that this is live video, right? The one thing important to use the camera is we may need to adjust the lens. Let me just open the front cover. Here we can adjust the lens. If the focus is not right, we can adjust the lens from here. I think the focus is okay. So let me just play back. And see, we also need to change the shooting angle. Let me just try in the shooting angle. Hold on. Okay, let me just change the shooting angle. Yes, I think that will be good. There's one more thing we are missing. You see, we didn't install the micro SD card, right? The camera support micro SD card, you can save the live video to the camera. Alright, I'm going to install this micro SD card to the camera, but before we do that, we need to disconnect the power from the camera, otherwise it's not going to work. So I'm going to disconnect the power. And now, I'll install the micro SD card. This is the place to install micro SD card. This is the pin of the card. The pin should face to the lens. So we need to push to the button. Now I think it's ready. And then we need to use this tape to cover the plane so it will still waterproof. Okay, I'm going to use this string tape to cover the open. That will be it. Okay. Now the camera's ready. Let's get back to the apps. Oh, sorry. It still didn't pop. That's the problem. And I'm going to hand the birdhouse with the camera to the tree. Now the birdhouse and the camera's hand on the tree. This is the power cord and supply the DC power for the camera. The power cord is connecting to a 10 meter extension cable coming from the AC outlet. So the whole connection is waterproof. Also the camera is also waterproof. And now I can watch the live video on my mobile phone. This is live video from the camera. And here is the full screen. Actually, not only I can watch the camera, even my friend or my family, as long as they can install apps and connect to the camera, they can see the camera on their mobile phone. They even can watch the camera remotely, not even stay in this house. In the next video, we're going to see how we can access the camera by using the PC computer or Mac. Now we are using the mobile phone, so we can use the Mac as well. Alright, that's all for today's video. If you have any question, please post in the comment section below. See you next time.